We still have some time before the Miyagi Academy Card Fight Club hits the Japanese format. So before we're going to go into those videos, I want to do a couple more deck profiles from the way back from the beginning of the reboot. And I promise to do Kagero for the longest of time. So today, I'm gonna fulfill the promise and we're going into the deck profile of Kagero. Stand up! Bangado! Hey card fighters, welcome back to another deck profile in the video, and today we're going to go back to the beginning of the reboot and let's talk about Kagero that came out at the Q4 set. So as a side note, we're not going to go over the cards that were introduced in the mini booster, as seen as this deck profile mainly focused around cards that came from Unite Team Q4, and as seen as this is going to be a focus completely around Waterfall, there's not going to be any Nouveau Vogue cards in this deck profile. We're going to do an updated version with Nouveau in it, but that's going to become later than this video. First, we're first going to go over some decks that are going to be updated by Miyagi Academy Club. So after this one, I want to talk about Oracle Think Tank. And if I have time left, I'm going to do the Exculpate updated deck from the Soul Saver one. So without further ado, let's jump right into this Kagero deck list. You know the drill, the timetable is onto my left. And there's nothing more to say about than that. So let's jump right into this deck profile. For this deck list, we run a total of 8 grade 3s, 12 grade 2s, 13 grade 1s, and 17 grade 0s. Your standard typical lineup that you see in most decks. We run, of course, the 4 copies of Dragon Egg Waterfall. Nah, I don't even need to go over this card why you should run it in your typical Kagero deck. It's just too good to not run it. We also run 4 Dragon Egg Overlord as our support grade 3, and also is a very great first right target, basically your only first right target for grade 3. And it can pressure out a lot of opponents that might falter beneath its re-standing hit pressure. For grade 2s, we run 4 copies of Dragonite Nahalem. He's just your typical grade 2 retire card to help you get rid of those pesky grade 1 booster cards or support cards. We also run 4 copies of Dragon Armor Knight. We run this particular card for the reason that it forces our opponent to call new cards to the field, as if they don't, they will leave this card unchecked on the field, and that gives us some easy free pressure on the field, whether our opponent can probably not deal with in the long term. We also run 4 copies of Berserk Dragon, and this is your main retire card and also your first, your main grade 2 right target, as it gives us a net plus 1. For grade 1s, we of course run 4 copies of Embodiment of Armor Bar. It's just a good versatile card that allows us to retire cards, just like Dragonite Nahalem. We also run 4 copies of Flame of Hope Ermo. This allows us to have some counter charge ability and also ability to go fast through a deck with drawing more cards, as seen as the deck basically is forced to rely on the top cards of the deck, as seen as we don't go through a deck as fast as most decks do. And lastly, to round it up, we have 3 copies of Lizard Soldier Apoya. This allows us to make some strong rear guard columns, as seen as that is our weakness. And with more rear guards retiring in a turn, this allows us to have more pressure in the field for free. And also we run 2 copies of Dragon Egg Gaius as an extra tech card, as this allows us to set up some OTK turns with Dragon Egg Overlord, but also with Dragon Egg Waterfall. For grade 0s, we run of course the obvious starter, and for Dragon lineup we run 4 heals, 5 crits, and 7 draws. Again, I run more draws to allow us to go faster for the deck to have more access to more cards. And the extra crits, I don't feel we need to have 8 crits, as Waterfall already provides its own crits, and Overlord as a re-stander allows us to get free pressure, and to help with Dragon Egg Gaius, we have enough crit pressure as it is, we now just need to have a way to fetch those cards. Just like Royal Paladin from Q4, this deck doesn't really have a combo to play, but you can use some card interactions to your advantage. By combining Repoya with Waterfall, you can create high power columns that are almost unguardable. You can also use Dragon Egg Gaius in combination with Waterfall to create a 3 crit attack to create a possible OTK turn, if they are sitting on a low guard value. But overall, the deck is quite one-dimensional when it comes to combos and plays. But it doesn't mean that this deck is just about placing units on the field and keep hitting with crits. No. But we get into that in a moment. Kagero is a deck that revolves around retiring rearguards from your opponent, and that is quite clear with the skills and how we use our resources. Because most of our resources are going towards retiring units
And only our grade 3 and Dragonic Gaius don't retire units with their skill that costs some form of resources. Even our countercharger only works if we retire a unit. So, Kagero equals retire. In most games, we won't have a big issue with counterblast thanks to Ermo, but always be aware on which units you most definitely want to retire to not waste some counterblast. Soul can become an issue if we use skills of Overlord, Bar and Berserk Dragon more extensively. We can get some soul with Dragonic Gaius, but to do so we need to use another counterblast, so we need to weigh our options. Waterfall soul cost won't be an issue as it fixes this by just rewriting, but as most of you know, it won't be any good if this is your first ride target. Therefore, we play Overlord. As we've seen with all the skills, we have a lot of different retire skills. Bar removes a grade 2 or lower in the same column, Nahalem snipes a back row unit, Waterfall retires a grade 2 or higher, and Berserk Dragon is the most versatile of the units as he can retire anything. But all these cards have one thing in common, and it's that their skill only works when they are placed. Meaning if you call one of these cards and you don't have a valid target, you basically are calling down a vanilla card. But don't think this is a bad thing, as you need to put out more pressure against your opponent than with just only your Vanguard. So in some scenarios, just slamming down a vanilla card is good enough. But we have a card in our deck that can combat this, and that is Dragon Armor Knight. Because of his skill, our opponent is forced to call some units to the field or accept that they need to deal with a 15k, potentially 23k attack, each and every turn. Skills of Ermo or Repoya can be activated with any type of retire, meaning that we can attack a rearguard boosted with Ermo, and if they let the rearguard die, we can then use Ermo's skill, meaning we got an 11k power boost power out of Ermo instead that we just retired. Kagero's main pressure comes from the Vanguard, Overlord's hit resistant ability, and Waterfall's powerful full crit attack with a Sentinel block makes these attacks the most powerful tools to overpower your opponent. This also is reflected in how you use your force markers. Unlike Royals, where you usually put them under your rearguards to have more overall powerful attacks, in Kagero you put them underneath your Vanguard to have an almost unstoppable Overlord or Waterfall. The downside to this, however, is that your overall pressure is very low. Most of your rearguards won't be very threatening after their initial ability turn. So in some scenarios, it might be wise to put a marker on your rearguard circle to have two powered up attacks instead of one. But remember, unlike Royals, we don't have an easy way to refill that circle. When that unit is destroyed, but at the same time, destroying rearguards won't be the main objective as seen as most Kagero cards are on place effect. And by destroying our rearguards, they give us a new circle to call units to. Let's talk about options. Side note, this build is solely focused around the Q4 support, so nothing from the mini booster. There aren't really a lot of other good cards from Q4 that are worthy to mention as an alternative options. Yeah, you can tech in the Cruel Dragon to have more early game pressure and potentially, if you're lucky, fix the first right waterfall turn. I've seen it happen a couple of times that Cruel Dragon hits a grade 3 with the soul charge to activate waterfall and win the game right then and there. For grade 1s, you can potentially run Dominance Dragon as it hits on its own, it allows for early pressure and it functions the same as Dragon Armor Knight, that it forces units from your opponent's hand to deal with this card. But this card can activate one turn earlier. As stated before, Kagero has issues revealing units, so having a grade 1 that can hit on its own is very nice to have. Now, for grade 2s, I have seen people swap Dragon Armor Knight out for Balakasti Dragon to have a potentially stronger attacker as it can stack more power. Also, it works just like Repoya, that it can power up if a rearguard is destroyed by battle. So you can get a more benefit from Overlord's attacking rearguard for its first attack if you have this card on the field. Kagero is a very beatdown control type deck where it tries to overpower your opponent by attacking with insane Vanguard attacks and destroying the field with its rearguard skills. Where Royal pluses by calling units to the field, Kagero initially pluses by mining to your opponent by destroying their units. So if your opponent doesn't call units to the field, then Kagero misses out on a lot of pressure. But Kagero has enough tools to deal with those situations that makes them one of the strongest control clan to date. And
And that's it for Kagros. Sadly, it's one of the more one-dimensional decks that came out in Unite Team Q4. But as soon as it was the first set of the reboot, not a lot of decks in this set had amazing combo potential or an amazing in-depth playability. Oracle Think Tank was the exception to this, as well as Nova Grappler. Only Nova Grappler was on the lower side of the power skill, so that one got really debooted at the beginning of the game. So I hope, but we're going to talk about that in another video later down the road. For Escagoros, it's still a very aggressive deck. It's a very beatdown style deck. It's still viable to this day, mainly because of how strong Waterfall is and the pressure that Overlord can give in the beginning game. So it's still a very viable deck. And if you like dragons, if you like power, if you like to scream a lot, then this deck is probably one for you. So let me know in the comments down below what you guys think of this deck profile and what Kagero in general. Maybe I missed something. Quick reminder, this is without the mini booster support. So if you're commenting stuff like you should add Nouveau Vogue or other of those cards, I know that's going to be in a more updated video. This is mainly about the vanilla version of the Waterfall deck profile. So let me know down below what you guys think and your ideas and maybe different strategies you can apply to this deck. I'm very curious to that. And as always, if you like this video, want to have more content in Vanguard style, then why not leave a like to the video, subscribe to the channel, hitting the bell button down below. And as always, guys, I'm Mr. Time Leap, and I see you guys in the next one.